sao? Provide the explanation in more detail. I will show in three main parts with three levels of problem. The first is the most comprehensive problem. This is the design workflow to coordinate discipline with online reach on engineering and BIMBLAS. The second is smaller, it still be important. Parametric design of brick model and tendon. And the third is also important, but more detailed. This is reinforcement modeling for rich components. And we will use online engineering to solve this. So finally, we will have some comments and question answer course. Now, the first part is design workflow to coordinate discipline in online. So we will discuss in three main parts and starting with coordinate with the other BIM models, followed by coordinate with the structural analysis, and is important. Ending with the manage structure on reinforcement model. So, looking at the screen, we can realize that in our today, when BIM workflow is very popular and important, as we can say it's it is important in design in Vietnam and also in many regions in the world. So especially in rich design, we can I think all of you hear the definition of LOD, it means level of detail. So it means it means that we should only show and achieve what we need in the model, not always we show all of them, and we have to choose the solution to divide model and just show the necessary information, necessary data for model to manage and to coordinate, collaborate. So based on the documents and my experience, I see the in rich design we have three main model, and you can see the first is structural model, mean a parametric model. We can modify and adjust some parameter and other thing related to it will be modified also and updated too. The second model is structural model, the model used to be detailed reinforcement, and the third is terrain model, and you can use to visualization or add in the correct terrain. So we should at least I think three of model or this model will be used to work in brick design. But now today we have a lot of software, a lot of platform, and the data room is also different, and the difficult is find out the platform to cover and get to bring together to manage well the information. That is the first issue, first problem I will figure out. That's coordinating model. That's how we will we can use in effective way. That's the first. The second is the some detail of model I will figure out. Because you only work well in all of in risk design if you work well in each model. So in this scope of presentation, I will focus on parametric model and structural model. So this is the second thing. And the third thing I also want to mention that's the how to coordinate with structural analysis workflow. So normally the BIM workflow and the structural analysis model is some way different, and it contains many potential risk and conflict data, and I will analyze with you after. So besides from a core model called a parametric model, we can we expected that we expect that we can get the structural analysis result and 4D, 5D data, and it should be so. So looking at this slide, we can realize that three main problem, and we have to solve each of them if we want to effective workflow in risk design. So we will discuss one by one. So this is the workflow content. How we can coordinate in Open BIM platform. So to make the more simple in brick design, I just show the coordinate between two software, BIM software 1 and BIM software 2. In BIM software 1, I take the on-plane as a symbol. And BIM software 2, we can add any software like civil 3D Revit, other like UC WinRock. Okay, and the main idea here is the Open BIM platform in the middle, and it will collect the data and from other software to manage in the best way. And after that, the BIM software, the user from BIM software is will be the only person who is responsible for their task, and they and the user in each software have the right to update, and the manager can manage the project easily in the open platform only. So it is the expectation of that workflow. So the question is, what is the Open BIM problem, Open BIM solution currently? So in my presentation, I will introduce the BIMLOS as a solution for this one to solve the first problem. So using BIMLOS, we can get many benefit to solve the current problem, because project today more and more complex. Time scale is more squeezed inside, and it made people and company have decision so rushed, and software is used in variable and not in a uniform. So it needs to be an Open BIM platform to coordinate. To more specific, we using Beamlet, we can show all of them. First, we can manage all of data in any structure you want. It means you can manage lots of things in your structure, and you can see you can manage any location in the model you want. You can also see the collision between elements, and then you can give the task, it means issue, to the responsible from Beam software, and they can update and send the and update the status after. So all of them can use in the website platform, so everyone have the account can use it easily. No need for Beam software installation. So you can use everywhere and everywhere, any device you can use. So to give more illustration, explanation, sorry, I will show you my screen about Beamlet, and you can it's my more easy. So this is my Beamlet when I log in. In Beamlet, you everyone have the default group, and you can go this project. Yeah. It's based on the API website. So it's very easy to log in and manage here. You can manage in your structure. Very detailed. Yeah. Okay. Lots of reinforcement and other object, but we can see easily here. There is a tendon detail or other MEB jet that is a how we can also see a slide to when you show weekly to your client, for example, this one very weekly. Yeah. And here you can create the filter in your expectation, for example. You can device in your is symbol material name, okay. Like this, apply. Okay, because this is the default model. So I can Okay, so this is we will come back later. We take the Y in the first time. So the beamless will solve the first problem of our workflow. The second thing is coordinate with the structural analysis. You can see in the right picture that we have a beam model and we have a structural analysis model also, but between them we almost don't have the platform or the solution to connect them. And in the left of slide, I show the common workflow and show the reason why the app have potential risk. You have a bridge model in the first version, and we also have the structural model in the other software, for example. After that, we have many updates because bridge design is iterative work, and we have a lot of update. And after updating, we have two model in this have different also. So if in the in the real project we have a lot of update and the data conflict between two model in more and more, and it's have a risk potential for that. So we need a solution. And I also recommend Beamless a solution for this, because from the online bridge is the solution, and it will use to create parametric model, and then it's also automated calculated the structural analysis results also. So you only have one model in one software, and after that we can import the final model to online engineering, and so it will come to the main workflow with Beamless, upload the model and reinforcement model to Beamless. And after that, receive the ECU file, ECF file to modify and move update. So after that, we have the final version. And that using this, we can have the only one model for structure. And also using it for a structural analysis model also. But it has also a disadvantage because currently we cannot solve with the steel truss bridge. Steel truss bridge is not in the scope of work of online bridge, but beside that, you can calculate every a lot of kind of bridge you can. And other way is when you update in online bridge model, online model in online engineering, you cannot automated update as you in online bridge. You only one way from update from online bridge model, and model in online engineering update one way like this. But it is not a big problem, because the change in online risk is very fast and it's so convenient. So you can have a small change and other part in online risk model can update it in this way. So you can use this way to compile structural analysis workflow and BIM workflow with the risk model reinforcement model. Yes, this is the first way. If you don't want to use online risk to make calculation, you can use this this workflow. I refer from online firm. That is, you will use other platform in BIMLUS called CCR Autoconverter. Using it, you can take the model in from that from online BIMLUS updated to from online engineering before. Using it, you can give the SAF format like Excel or connected directly with the analysis software, and we will make a calculation directly in the structural analysis software. I think this is good and good for on a bridge you want to design, because in my opinion, using each software with the best power would be and we can compile this well as and finally we will use the best result. So using this, we'll create the model and update to BIMLUS using the CR to communicate between risk model and analysis model. But go to this topic, it will take many time. So I will share with you and discuss with you more detail in other webinar. So we will move to the important part. This is managed structural and reinforcement model. Before moving to the discuss with the reinforced concrete model, we should confirm that nowadays the scope and the requirement of bridge and other infrastructure project is more complicated, and we have to decide the last span of bridge that which time schedule and the environment problem need to be considered. The second is structure type, reinforcement concrete structure, steel structure, and composite structure is change step by step in its proportion. So I think the future material will be steel and composites. But in this webinar, we will still mention the reinforced concrete model because it is a very common and easy to discuss. So it's it is the second one, and the last is new meta in construction. We have many new new method. So in each software, it should be contain the on up structure, and and after that, it can be useful for on-off structure and on-off method. So we will focus on the topic of today is reinforced concrete model. Now, if you remember the last workflow I saw, you can understand easier that symbol it more simple. This workflow show the communicate and coordination between online BIM project in online software and the open BIM platform on BIMBlus. Starting with divide the project from structural model and even a lot of reinforcement, and we should divide it in many parts. For example, project part one for reinforcement of girder, a bridge, and part two for pier and foundation, for example. So in each project, each small project, we will upload directly in BIMBlus with this icon and AFC file also. And after that, in each project, we will receive the ECU and BCF files, and we will update following this to get the final model. And on updates will can be managed in BIMBlus. And this is my recommend model to workflow. Okay, the next is you can see if you coordinate in this way, we can use the in BIM model environment in the left side. We can manage directly model both 3D and 2D view in the same time. We can very easy to manage and design it. And the right picture is data coordination between discipline. It is template in neutral environment called BIMBlus. And you can see this because I show you in the first up webinar. So now I open the BIMBlus project. You can see here. This is the rich model. Is open here. You can change the transparent. Yeah. This is the bridge. In this bridge, we have many object, general object, and reinforcement. You can change the transparency of it to see what you want. For example, this is the model of bridge, it's a abutment and pie cap. With the bridge project with many reinforcement item, we can manage and see easily. You can see. Yeah, and I create a tendon model also. This one, is you can create a section. To see easier. What's about this? It. You can see the chain of section here. Like this, and we will use one right. Yes. Okay. We'll come back. And the other thing we can take advantage from bridge model and reinforcement model, we can export automatically the table and regenerate drawings easily in many standard from Vietnamese standard, Europe standard, or even ACI standard America. Yeah. So with the first part is very important to help you realize the problem in our current workflow in grid design and find out where is the problem we should improve. So after that, we will focus in the second thing, the each model I mentioned. This is parametric model design of bridge model and tendon. So, and with the online bridge software, we can show it. This bug contains four small bugs. From general workflow of parametric model, how to create bridge structural member, standard model for bridge, and finally is advanced assembling for completed model. Okay, looking at this, you can understand how we can design in bridge model. Very simple. You can use five steps. Step one and step two. Step one, you will create the axis of bridge in double curve. You can use directly in online bridge, and you can design in civil 3D, for example, and import in online. It is the same. And the second, you will you have to create a section with the various variable and variation function. It will be used to define the components and the chains, the special chain. Look like the girder. You see. The girder is the chain from the support to the span is smaller, for example, and it makes the curve. So you can use the Excel and to create the table of variation. So don't worry about this many work to do. So after the two steps, you can create the components like foundation, pier, girdle also, and tendon. Okay, and from this you can create the final structural model. If you compile with the smart placement to create more detailed object, and you can test it to get the structural analysis results and 4D model also. So this is the main workflow of parametric bridge in online bridge. So to more specific, we can create bridge structural model in three main components, three types. The vertical component, you can see the pie cup and PA. The horizontal component is, you can see, you can create a girder, the main girder, box girder, beam hit. Is easy, depend on your design idea. And the compromise, the mixed component, I mean, this this guy is a woman, and you will you have to compile the between vertical component and horizontal component. You can easily very easy for engineer. Yeah, it's the I think we can take a look in model. So, yeah. So, I think you know how to use an open online bridge, but I would like to introduce you more. So, this is the final model. Oh, okay. You can when you open the project with the this catalog here. Yeah. You can create in the desktop for symbol here. Yeah. Okay. Project one, can name it. You can put your project in any folder you want. Okay, here, workflow, you can create axis. Oh, very easy. New axis. Hey. Can create this symbol, and you can we will follow the design from 2D plane and define the coordinate of of axis bond. Yeah, and we can find, for example, plane. This one. Yes. And you see the axis in the plane. Then we will define the profile. Yeah. First one we can this. Second thing.
side. Okay.
So you can create the axis. For this symbol. And after we have the asset, we will create the cross section, new cross section. You can define with your or you will import use the available file. I will recommend you you should divide your work in other members and your you will compile this in the project with the import and export here. And we have export import. For example, we will Yeah, this is the axis. Yeah. For the outbridge, we can re-ace the main axis and other horizontal axis and transverse axis, and it's we'll put the beam hit and transverse beam. Yeah, it's very easy. So you can for symbol we open. It very fast and quickly. You can create the main section. Yes. So after you have on a section unit and axis, you will you can create the main model. You also use in TCL file. Yeah. Yeah. This model. You can hurry. Yeah, it looks better. So this you can see. Yeah. We can sum vertical component. Yeah. We have to define a lot of section like this cross section, and the best way is that event from order. And after that, and it is variation I mentioned before. Yeah. You can use Excel to create a table in is the fast way, and it's you also you only use a copy and paste here, and you can have the chart like this, very simple. Yeah, you have to define a lot. Yeah, this one. Now, first is axis with a lot of transverse axis, cross section with a lot of tie, variation is structural member. Yeah, here, first component mean peer from T1 to three. To T6, T1, T2, T3, T4, 5, 6. And in the head of bridge is abutment, ME, MA, and MB. Yeah. So this is the vertical component you can create easily. And this is the pier, but girder you can create. This is the beam Here, yeah. You can see here. Yeah. The bridge design is in it. This have a gap between three parts. It's the precast element, and we have to split here. So we have connect between pier and girder be above by this. So we have to define this as the beam to connect easier beam hit. And we have also the beam here. Define this. This is the beam also. Girder component will connect it. And first, continue to box girder here. You can create the variation with variation of height. Look like this, yeah. Okay, we will continue. This is the bridge structural member. And the next is a tendon model in bridge. You, as you can see in beam plus, we also have a tendon model, and we also create in bridge online bridge also. In the cross section, we will define the bridge bond system, and in the bridge we also need define tendon curve and link the right bond. So the tendon will be created automatically. Yeah. Like this. And the last of parametric models is order detail. For example, a tenant hit support item at the below the girder. Yeah. And to do the this detail item, we will use the smart placement in online bridge. The black arrow you see. You can see the placement. Yeah. And BA. I will place the reference bond here, and it will be used for the smart placement reference bond. And I clean it to online engineering. Yeah, this is the bridge model import from online bridge, and we will use only import online bridge. Very easy. Yeah, and on the horn model from online bridge will be imported in this. I will show the tendon. Standard. Simple. And we will see this is the tendon hit. Also. Is in another way we can only have the tendon curve, but if we want to create tendon hit like this, this is the one the first type of placement, and the second is for tendon. Tendon. You can you only need you only define the anchor at begin. You just give the name like this, and in the online engineering you need to only create the object to use for tendon hit. Tendon hit A here. So online read and online answering will be automatically linked together and create the exact tendon hit here. This will use the tendon system very visualized and exactly. So this is the tendon hit with the smart placement feature. And we will move to the next is the also important reinforcement modeling for bridge component. And this in this part, I will introduce you how to design the reinforcement model for components from foundation, pier, girder, and abutment. You see. Looking this, we also have the general model, and we can image easily. First, we will get the model from online bridge. We have also this. We have the final model in online engineering, and after that, we will have organize the model at building structure and define the drawing. So we will decide where we will put the reinforcement, where we put the model, for example. And we also define the option, how to reason the label, for example, standard, like this. And the and we will create the reinforcement using the available feature of online. We will choose the bending shape, any bending shape you can use. Then we can place it in the section or along the path. Yeah, and or even you can use reinforcement area. It also the type of function. And using it, we can create on-off repair model in for component a bridge. Finishing this, you can export the drawing and report easily. PDF, DWG, this app format or Excel format. Yeah. In the final of webinar, I will show you the risk model in the online engineering. So first, I will go through the main component. You can see rebar foundation. With this, we will we can create rebar model for case lapping, pour pipe cap, pour pipe. Pie cup, and this for pour pie, you can use the cage lapping method for longitudinal rebar. Besides this, we can also create spiral ring rebar. So here, and this is foundation rebar for foundation. Yeah, you can. Create two side main rebar on the bottom and the top of pie cup. Side rebar, also starter rebar or pier of variable rebar if we have a slope of pie cup. Yeah. This is the rebar for pier. This is the typical pier. We can we have to create a horizontal rebar, a vertical rebar, and a starter rebar for girder, yeah. And rebar for girder is the most complex in bridge model, because the axis bridge can be very complicated, and the girder will be follow this. And also based on the method of construction of bridge, we can design a repair model for each the parts step by step. And you can see we have the repair model for one section of girder, and this have an opening, and the starter lapping for other part of girder. Yeah, you can use the function of rebar to react here. Extrude a long part or sweep part along part and extrude along part. Now I will show you how to create. Yeah. For a curve with double curve bridge model, we will use create section at the hit up girder and put the bar shape, bending shape in this section. Any shape you can put is. And sweep bar along bar and choose the bending shape, then the path along the ridge to be chosen. Yeah, escape, and the rebar is created automatically. Other bending shape is also related in this way. We can define bending shape like this. Rebar along the tendon. So. Now, this very quickly. You can divide in many drawings so you can manage show and hide. You even show the bar max symbol. Read the label for it. Diameter, mark number. And even create the quantity setup of bending schedule. Yeah, is it automatically? So this is the short video of design of rebar for girder. For the rebar abutment, is you can in this component we will use compile bar shape span reinforcement with bar along path on up method to create it reinforcement for it. This is the model or up reinforcement, and beside the common method, you also have the smart part is the developed from Python from online. We can use the smart part or Python part to create reinforcement automatically. After I will show you here. We come back to the model bridge. Change to you can see this is the horn model of bridge exported from online bridge. And we can create more building, more to manage drawing, reinforcement, support, lateral beam, foundation, beam, box girder. Yeah. First is foundation. Yeah. We will open the reinforcement of foundation. Pie cap and pour by. Yeah. Pie cap and pour by model also. Pie cap. Model. Table. We have model here. That's a model. Lot up rebuy. So this so. I created the rebar for pies. Let's see. Transparent chain. Yeah. You can see here. Yeah. Và bài and the model for this is the pi and we move to pi cap. We can in online we the drawings is divided many in into many parts, so you can create your reinforcement model of each part in a separate drawing and it made the whole of model can be managed easily and not so large and is the model. So I will introduce you the fast way with using a smart path like this. That's more here. This is a smart path also used by rack into the environment here. And we can define the length of pie cap thickness. And 1000 surface you can you can do any this. Okay, and other parameter rebar, you can set rebar bottom in x direction and y direction. This is the diameter, spacing, top rebar we can the same with bottom. We use define for each direction like this. Very convenient. This way you can do same. Pin along bar rebus upside the L shape reinforcement or additional or rebar. We can divide all of them. So after that, we can finish the workflow. This is the smart pie cup model. Can show very quickly to create a reinforcement model for pie cup. And this is the way with using the smart path. And I also introduce about the sweep path along path for girder components. This should be used, and the basis feature here you can use for other like pie or a woman. So the next I want to show you in the Beamless with the model. And after you have the on up repair model unit, you can upload into the Beamless if you have a design, if you have an account. You can upload to Beamless here. You can log in. And after that, you can connect and upload, update, and create new revision into Beamless. So the finally, you can get this here. The whole model with using it, we can manage in the website platform, and it's more easier and more slider, and very easy. No need for use any Beam software, and you can manage well. Yeah, it's okay. We come back to the slide. So this is on up 10 I want to share in this webinar, and I hope you can I can contribute to the workflow design of Bridge, and hope you can integrate that you can trace your problem and fix something, and consider is very important. Yeah. So here, if you have any question, let's give this below, and we will discuss. Or even